This is Winchbot, my robot arm that is composed of servos and three winches. Keep the levers short when using servos for creating a robot arm. To get a large work area, I mounted a compact robotic arm made of 5 servos on a square tube that is hanging on 3 steel cables. The length of the steel cables can be varied by winches. Those winches are driven by geared electric motors controlled through sensor feedback. I have explained the working principle of that drives in detail in previous videos. Most parts of this robot were cut with my CNC version 3.2 from 5mm polycarbonate sheets. Polycarbonate is hard to process manually. If you don't own a CNC, use 5mm plywood instead. Ball bearings are used to mount the drums of the winches that have a built-in transmission with 60 teeth gear wheels on top. Originally I used a sensor disc with 30 teeth and a gear wheel with 15 teeth on the output shafts of the drive motors. It's tricky to align the sensors on the discs with the 3mm teeth and gaps. Furthermore, the number of pulses generated by that encoder is close to the limit of the Arduino. That's why I replaced the sensor discs with 12 teeth versions. To get a higher torque, I have also replaced the gear wheels on the output shafts of the DC motors with 8 teeth versions. An eye formed by a piece of wire defines the deviating point of the steel cables. The three winches are arranged on the vertices of an equilateral triangle with an edge length of 1 meter, composed of square tubes. An Arduino Uno that is also mounted on the frame controls the three winches by 3 H-bridges and a total of 6 transmissive optical sensors. The square tube with the servos is guided at the center point of the triangle in such a way that it can move in axial direction and spin around 2 axes. The steel cables are mounted near the bottom of the square tube. The tiny robot arm composed of 5 servos is at the lower end of the square tube. 2 of the servos are needed to align the robot arm in parallel to the plane below the winchbot. Servo number 1 keeps the robot arm in parallel to the Y axis, and servo number 2 aligns the arm in parallel to the X axis. Servo number 3 rotates the gripper, servo 4 tilts the gripper, and servo number 5 is used to open or close the gripper. The frame is hanging on the ceiling of my photo studio and it must be aligned in parallel to the table below, which is done by a rope and simple homemade screw clamps. The software needs to know the cable length at the starting point. To adjust that initial length, I'm using 60cm aluminum bars on the cables. With the control software running on the Raspberry Pi, all 3 cables are aligned to that initial length. More starting parameters needed are the initial length of the square tube from the mount point of the steel cables to the bearing at the frame, or the distance between the eyes of the winches. The cable length according to each point in the XYZ space as well as the servo angles are calculated by the control software. The WinchBot is an ideal machine to refresh your knowledge about the Pythagorean theorem or to teach trigonometry. Details about the maths behind the WinchBot are available on the project page. The computing power of the Raspberry Pi does all the calculation work for you. You can control the Pi directly through a wireless keyboard. The software runs in a terminal by what you can get remote access with ease through a secure shell session. With a camera connected to the Raspberry Pi you can also observe the robot remotely, thanks to the internet. With the cursor keys, the WinchBot can be commanded along three axes. Whenever servo 3 is triggered to turn the gripper, the winches are controlled in such a way that the pivot axis runs through the tip of the gripper. Same is for servo number 4 that tilts the gripper. The software controls the robot arm to make the tip of the gripper being the pivot point, by what it is more easy to move the WinchBot manually to a given point in space. With the keyboard you can command the WinchBot and store points in a file. After storing a sequence you can replay the commands by selecting the accordant file. As you can see, the robot arm moves not very smooth, which is why I had to record some of the video sequences more than once. The feedback of the sensor discs is very rough. In theory, a movement of one sensor pulse is approximately 0.5 mm, and you must consider that the control software ignores an error of up to 3 pulses between the set point and actual point. With that, the movement is divided into 1.5 mm steps. To get better results, a higher number of sensor pulses per millimeter of movement as well as an improved version of the control software are needed. Bipolar stepper motors in micro-stepping mode would be a good choice. A fourth winch with a steel cable running to the top of the square tube could be an improvement as well. With that you can apply a constant load on the cables, by what the work area would also grow slightly. At this winch spot, gravity keeps tension on the cables. An automatic brick feeder would also be nice, here I am the servant of this machine. Nonetheless, even in its current stage, the robot finally made its job and arranged all 20x40x5mm bricks as commanded by the coordinates stored in a file. This raw version of WinchBot is first and foremost meant to be an educational tool. You can get the build instruction on the project page. If you'd like to support me in developing more machines and to teach the knowledge behind, use the donate button on homofazients.de. Thanks to all backers that already made a donation. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.